Hello, everyone, and welcome to Street Smart Investing. I'm your host, Albert, and as you can see, it is just pouring here in Florida. I'm here in my cars, and as you can see, it's pouring. It's a thunderstorm here. Today is April 18th. It is 7:23 p.m., and today I'm in my car for the first time doing this video. A video in my car, but I'm waiting for this rain to stop a little bit more, and so I'm going to evaluate the two companies that I said that were on my survey. So the two companies that I have are Star, S-T-A-R, and S-A-F-E. So let's begin. Let's look at that. I'm going to start with Safe first, because that was the company that was on the survey. So let's begin. Let's take a look at that. Let's take a look at that company. So let's begin here. So Safe, let's look at that. Then let's look at the info here. I'm going to start it off. Again, I'm not a licensed investor, so if you're gonna invest in the stock market, be sure to be advised by a financial advisor or somebody who is certified. All that good stuff. So, here we go. So we have Safe Hold Inc. They are formerly Safety, Income, and Growth Inc. That sounds like the portfolio that I've created. So anyways, formerly primarily to acquire, own, manage, finance, and capitalize ground net leases. So that's a good sign. The company's portfolio consists of 12 properties, includes DoubleTree Seattle Airport, One Ally Center, I don't know what that is. Hilton Salt Lake, I don't know what that is. DoubleTree Mission Valley, I don't know what that is. DoubleTree Sonoma, DoubleTree Durango, Dallas Market Center. It sounds like a food shopping center, I guess. Sheraton Suites, that sounds like a hotel, I guess. Northside Force Hospital Medical Center, so that's good. Nassau/JPSS headquarters. The Buckler Apartments, Dallas Market Center, Marriott Courtyard, and Lockup Self-Storage Facility. So it seems like they're doing a few hotels. They have an airport. This DoubleTree, I don't know, it might be an apartment. Apartments, I guess. So they do have apartments. They're a little bit diversified. But yeah, they are a diversified REIT. They could be a little bit more diversified, and the second secondary sector that falls under is residential and commercial. I'm a little bit uncomfortable. Let me try to reposition this. Sorry. So there we go. It's a little bit better. The rain is going away, so I'm gonna try to hurry up with the video. So we have I'm sorry guys, I'm uncomfortable in this car. Can't even, there we go. Okay. There we go. So now let's begin so let's start up from the top. So we have the price is at $68.85, market cap $3.67 billion, PE ratio of 58, earnings per share 1.1, that's good. Dividend, good. Dividend yield, kind of low, but at least they're paying a dividend. Hopefully they can put a rising dividend. The growth rate seems pretty good. I need to see something. Okay, that was from a year, so that's not bad. Because a lot of these stocks, especially from March of last year, they've been gaining, so that's what you want to see. That's the momentum, really, from the lows of March, late March. And we have any news? First quarter earnings of 2021. Oh boy, that doesn't look good. Safety, income, and growth. Q1 earnings expected to decline. Announces $1 billion unsecured revolving credit facility. They announce a new credit facility. They're expected to decline, but analysts are having it as a buy, the majority. So 50% and 60, so that'll be 62.5% as a buy, and the rest is hold. So then we also have the 1 year chart is going up. Okay. Dividends per share, so rising dividends, yeah, so they've been going up. You know something, hold up, they paid out in January, March, June, September, and then December, so they paid out five times in 2020. Oh, I'm mistaken. Hold on. Next dividend date? Oh, okay. Never mind. Yeah, they did. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, rising dividend. No splits. So they missed earnings, missed. They gained. They probably hit. So now they just gotta beat that. Yeah, I would like to see them beat that because they missed these two quarters. Numbers are not bad. The numbers are not bad and their margins went up. What is their debt? 56, that's not bad. This is not a bad company. Actually pretty good. They went up in 2020. Cash flow. Yeah, they're pretty good. They're number one on the earnings. PE is pretty high. Dividend is pretty, yield is low, but I mean, they're paying something. So, good company. I'll buy it on the dip. Yeah, so definitely a good company. They're the top earner, so you can't even compare it to that. So now let's go to Star and review that. That was pretty fast. So Star, let's go with Star. So iStar finances, invest, and develops real estate and real estate projects. The net lease portfolio consists of properties owned by the company and leased to single tenants. So pretty much properties, real estate properties, and land. Another diversified REIT. Let's see their rankings real quick. So good, 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 good. They beat their estimates. Oh, I don't like that. The returns. Negative returns. Star PRD. No, not PRD. Net margin went in the negatives. The debt is too high. I'm not fond of it. Net income, revenue. Yeah, I'm not feeling it. Nope. I'd stay away from this company. The net income and their debt. Yeah, it's not happening. Yeah, they don't have much cash flow. Negative earnings. Yeah, I'd stay away from this company. They've got a lot of work to do. I'm not into it. They have rising dividend, but yeah, the share price is that they've been going up steadily. I mean, it's still cheap though. I like Safe better. I really do like Safe, but let me see. They are number 6 in diversified REIT. So yeah, I stay away from this company. I'm not fond of it. I don't really like it. I looked at the numbers, the balance sheet, the return. I don't like it. Sorry. Safe is a better investment. And, that's all there is to it. So, tell of the tape, let's look at, Star. PE ratio doesn't show here, but I believe it was in the negative. $1.36 billion company, negative earnings, negative 0.87, dividend of 44 cents. Yield is at 2.40%, which is higher, and share price looks better and higher, but they've been beating their earnings. See, but what I don't get is their cash flow is awful. Let me see their net, because hold on, let me see something. Let me see their net. That was in 2020. Okay, I got it. They beat their earnings, but then they probably had negative earnings for 2020. No, I don't get it. So the returns are still supposedly not as good as they should be, and they're not earning what they should be. I think that's what it is. They're not, even though they're beating their estimates, I don't know. That's weird, because Wall Street gave them these estimates and they've beaten them, but then they're still in the negative. So who knows? They're not getting, they're probably in debt. That's probably why. That's why they're probably in the negative, because they keep raising their debts. This is a company that needs to be further investigated and looked. But I'm not too fond of it. So there you have it. Diversified REITs. Star and Safe. I evaluated both companies. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one, guys.